about the promises of the Lord. Sijui ni wangapi ambao wanajua kenye Mungu amewaahidi. Father, we thank you because of this time. We pray that God, you may speak to us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, as we look to your promises, may we understand them, may we fathom about what you have told us in your word. For your glory, and it is in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. The other day, there's a time I started on the promises of God. Unajua sisi wa Kristo wakati mwingi hatujui ni nini Mungu aliyotuahidi katika maandiko. Wewe unaomba tu na hujui unaomba nini. You know, the best kinds of prayers are those prayers you pray the word of God. You know, there are so many promises in the word of God. That Bible that you're holding today, it is full of great promises. I've been trying to study on the promises of God. And imebadilisha sana jinsi naona mambo na jinsi navyoomba. Because when you know what God has said about a situation, then you know how to pray right. Because already you have an answer. Are you getting what I'm saying? You know, ukisha anza kufafanua maandiko. Unajua wakati mwingine tumekuwa tumeokoka kwa wakati mrefu sana. Lakini ukiuliza mtu as God just one scripture hajui kabisa. Lakini huu ni wakati ambapo wana wa Mungu. We are being called to go to the basics. Amen. Knowing and studying the word of God. Najua unashika mingi sana ambazo zinakusumbua. But the situation, the solution is in the word of God. And let me put it to you this morning. Hakuna jambo ambalo umepitia ama utakalo pitia ambalo halijanenewa katika Biblia hiyo umeshika. Amen. Na answers zote, they are in this Bible. This is our directory. Wakati umeshikwa na jambo, where do you go to get your solutions? It should be in the word of God. Watu wengine, they call people to counsel them and to speak to them. Lakini hakuna kitu ambacho kinachopita hili neno la Mungu.
Amen.
Amen. The promises of God for those people who have studied about them. Some of the people say there are over 3,000 promises of the Lord. Hata ukishika tu moja jinsi Caleb alishika moja. You know, Caleb dwelt on one promise. And even when he was old, he said, give me that mountain that Moses promised me. Amen. You can just dwell on one promise of the Lord. And some people say there are over 7,000 promises in the word of God. This is wonderful. Our God is a promise maker. Amen. Unajua katika ulimwengu ambao tunakaa, so many promises are broken. Sije kama umeshaahidiwa kitu na mtu, na that promise was never kept. Na si watu tu, hata sisi, we are not good in promise keeping. Amen. Na ebu kufikiria kini uli promise mtu fulani, but you never delivered. Wakati tulipokuwa tunakuwa, wazazi wetu walituambia, ukipita mtihani, hata mimi nimeshaambia watoto wangu, ukipita mtihani nitakununulia baiskeli. Lakini wakati wa kununua baiskeli ukifika kunakuwa na jambo lingine. Ati si saa hizi. But I want to speak about our God who is a promise keeper and a promise deliverer. Amen. Mungu wetu si kama mwanadamu. When he promises anything, can I ask you, do you know God has promised you breakthrough in your life? Do you know God has promised provision for your life? Do you know God has promised peace for your life? Do you know God has promised you a good marriage for your mate, for your life? Do you know what God has promised you concerning your children? Do you know what God has promised you concerning eternal life? Do you know God has promised you unfailing love? Watu wengine wanasema sidhani kuna mtu ambaye ananipenda. Maana hawajui jinsi Biblia inasema. Inasema ya kwamba I have loved you with an everlasting kind of love. That is a promise from the Lord. So many people, they don't know about forgiveness. You know, when the Bible says, I have forgiven you. When God says, I have forgiven you, it is a promise. When you repent, when you come to Him and repent, I will forgive you. And I will separate you away from your sins. I'm just putting a foundation. Mungu ametuahidi so many things. God has promised us the Holy Spirit. To tumesomewa na Mrs. Kawanja this morning. I was feeling like I'm getting excited. God has promised to make us His friends. The Bible says, now you're no longer slaves but friends. Hallelujah. Rachel is a friend of God. Hey! Oh my God. nikwambie jinsi Mungu anavyosema. Lakini Biblia yangu ikishasema jambo, hili jambo ni kweli. It cannot be refuted in the name of Jesus. We are talking about the promises of the Lord. You know, when you go to pray, what do you pray? Do you just do that? Just so many people say, spend a lot of time. I have done that for many years. We spend a lot of time saying nothing before the Lord and just crying. But there is a difference between a child of God who knows exactly what the Lord has said. You know, when you stand, let me give you an example. When you're praying for your children, for those who have children, what do you tell the Lord about your children? What does the Bible say about my children? This is what I'm praying. Amen. I will say, my children are for signs and wonders. My children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be their peace. My children will inherit the Gentiles. This is the word of God. There are so many scriptures. When you pray for breakthrough, what do you declare? The Bible says, I shall bless you in the book of Deuteronomy. Until you're so much blessed, you shall lend to nations and you shall not borrow. Amen. I know we are getting along. Unajua ukishajua Mungu amekuahidi presence yake, ya kwamba nitakuwa pamoja na wewe. Matthew 20:28. And I shall be together with you until the end of time. So how utatembea kama uko peke yako? Utatembea ukijua Mungu presence yake iko pamoja na mimi. Aliambia Jacob, I shall go together with you until I take you to the promise, the place that I promised you. That is our portion in the name of the Lord. The presence of the Lord. I just want to highlight a few. There are over 7,000 promises in the word of God. Are you sick? Do you need healing? Unajua wakati mwingine tunapoenda kuomba healing, we just say, God, Mungu niponye katika jina la Yesu. But don't you know 2,000 years ago at Calvary, Jesus has already paid for it? You just receive it in the name of Jesus. No, when you know the truth sets you free. The Bible says, they shall know the truth. Wanapojua ukweli, hu ukweli utawaweka huru. Does God promise to bless you at the work of where you at the hands of your work of your hands? Yes. What does the Bible say? Amen. Nataka sasa uanze kufikiria hiyo kitu ambayo unataka katika maisha yako. I'm not going to take long, but I want just to highlight, it is a very big topic. Lakini hicho kitu ambacho umekuwa unatafuta, it is in the word of God. Amen. One day my son was sick. I love this testimony. And my husband was not there. He had gone to a mission. And now, Mwacha was so sick. And he lay in bed. And I could see his color turning. Ilikuwa na turn purple. Na wakati huo sikuwa najua nifanye nini. You know, you have tried everything. Jesus, I pray that you may heal this baby. It is not working. And I felt I had to peruse the Bible. Nilishika Biblia yangu ilikuwa kwa mfuko nikaitoa hapo kwa kitanda. I spent so much time researching. Kwa sababu pastor alikuwa ametuambia hiyo Sunday ya kwamba you can stand on the promises of God. Na mimi nilikuwa natafuta promise nisimama nayo tu machozi iniondoke. Amen. I was tired of going to the hospital. I was tired of feeding my babies with medicine. So I stood and I said, God, I know there is a word for my son. I am going to research on it. I'm going to find it and I'm going to declare it. I went and found John 16:23. The Bible says, until now you have not asked me. Hallelujah. Mbaka sahizi haujaniuliza kitu chochote. Mbaka sahizi haujambia Mungu kenye unachotaka. Ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be complete. Right then in that situation, I needed a miracle. Amen. Unajua wakati mwingine ukienda mbele za Mungu, you don't pretend. God knows everything you're passing through. Mungu anaelewa jinsi unavyolia kisirisiri. And he wants you to be open. And I told God, you see, I've not been sleeping. I've been looking at this boy. You know it, my father. I've spent so many days going to the hospital. We are depleting funds because of this baby. Now, Lord, you have told me. Until now, I have not asked you. I told the Lord, I ask you in the name of Jesus that healing may come to this baby in the name of the Lord. And he received it and he has never been sick again. Yeah. Hallelujah. This is a faithful God. When you know what God has said in his word, then you stand on the word of God. Is it sickness? Is it luck? Is it supply? Do you know God promises to supply all our means according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Amen. Lakini wakati mwingi tunalilia watu, but we don't know who we are. When you know who you are, you start commanding things. You have authority and power to command things. You are a child of God. Hallelujah. Mtoto wa rais akikuja hapa, ata behave kama sisi kweli. He knows what he is. He knows who is behind him. We know who is behind us.
Amen.
Hey, yes, I know who is backing me. Yes, I cannot fear, because God says, I will be together with you. I will supply all your needs according to my riches in glory. What need is it? Unajua watu wengine, we don't believe that our God is able, but our God is able. Amen. Let me start from there. Our God is able. How do we depend on the promises of God? Yes, Mungu amesema nitapona. Man, 2019 I was so sick. Sikuwa naamka kwa kitanda 6 months. Nini hamkujua? Nilikuwa nakuja hapa nasikia tukiimba ni kama nitaanguka. But our God, I stood on the promise of God. If you ask me the scriptures about healing, I know them often. I have prayed them so many times. And I told God, I know that you are not alive. You have to fulfill it in my life. Lazima nipone katika jina la Yesu. I went to the hospital, they gave me drugs. But I knew there is a greater power. Oh, the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. The price that he paid for me is so great. Amen. You know, I kept on reading Isaiah 53 verses 5. By his stripes I've been healed. By his stripes I've been healed. By his stripes I've been healed. Amen. I think 2 Peter 2:24. Peter is narrating of an event that has already bypassed. He's saying, by his stripes we were. Amen. The other day I taught my son this, and he prayed for his brother, he received healing. You know, when you know what you carry, when you know the anointing that is in you, see wengine waliitwa, mimi niliitwa na ukaitwa, upako ni nao na upako unao. Amen. Biblia inasema ya kwamba in the book of Mark, and those who shall believe in me, I think Mark 16:17, those who shall believe in me, this sign shall follow them. They shall cast out demons. They shall speak in new tongues. They shall lay their hands on the sick and they shall recover. It is our time in the name of Jesus. Authority we have already been given. Tumeshapewa mamlaka. Sasa ni tuanze kutumia hii mamlaka in the right ways. How can we depend on the promises of God? Yani Mungu umeshaniahidi ya kwamba I'll get everything. I'll get breakthrough. I'll get all these things that you have promised me. I'll get a good mate. By the way, Biblia inasema kwamba none of you shall lack a mate. That is a promise. And a good mate for that matter for the children of God. Amen. You know, the Bible says, I want to tell you, how can we depend, just right if you're ready. Why should we depend on the promises of God? Number one, because God is able. Mungu ana uwezo. Amen. Unaweza promise mtu kitu, wakati wa kufulfill hiyo promise ushindwe. Because maybe ulimwahidi utampea kadhao, ulimwahidi utampea something, but at that time you don't have it. Lakini I came to preach about a God who is able. Wajua sisi tumeokoka, lakini we limit God. One of my friends told me something that I've been thinking about. That we have limited God to 50 shillings. We have limited God to a provision of 1,000. We have limited God to a provision of 10,000. But do you know God is able to give us any amount that we can desire? Amen. Don't know why people are so quiet, but I see they are getting it. Our God is able. Sarah and Abraham, sitaki kurudia story ya Sarah na Abraham, they had zero ability. Yani hawangeweza. These guys were past childbearing age. Yani hawakuwa na uwezo wowote. Lakini Mungu ambaye Abraham aliamini, he was an able God. Amen. They did not have the ability. Walikuwa wamezeeka. Mpaka wakati Sara anasikia kwamba atapata mtoto anacheka. Najua kuna hiyo situation unaiangalia unacheka. Na inywe. Unaomba akinyanira. Because God, you said that I'm going to do this and this. Is it going to come to pass? And you have been limiting God. Unajua wakati mwingine we limit God to our capacity. Ya kwamba wewe hawezi pay up to 1,000. And you believe your God is not able to give you 10,000. Our God is able. Amen. The Bible says in the book of Romans 4:21, this is Abraham. Biblia inasema hivi. And being fully persuaded that what had been what he had promised, he was able to perform. Yani God is able. Mungu, God is able to heal you of cancer. God is able to heal you of diabetes. God is able to heal your children. God is able to restore your children. God is able. Unaweza kuwa umetafuta suluhu from everywhere na umekosa, but let me give you an assurance ya kwamba Mungu hajashindwa na ile jambo. It's just a matter of time and God changes everything. The Bible says at the right time I shall make everything beautiful. Hata ingawa mwanzo wako ni mdogo sana, you know some of us tumetoka mbali, lakini Biblia inasema ya kwamba hata kama mwanzo wako ni mdogo sana, your latter end shall surely increase, because we believe in an able God.
Amen.
Amen. Mungu ambaye Abraham alimtumaini. You know, Abraham believed that his God is able. Yes, I am old. Yes, I have zero ability. Yes, I'm not able to give myself children. But the God I have believed in is able to give me that child of a promise. Amen. The second thing, I want to lay a foundation. Why should we depend on the promises of God? Yani mimi niamini ma promises za Mungu kwa nini? Because of his track record. Unajua mtu anajulikana kwa track record yake. Unajua when people are reading about people's history, wanasema hapa, yani in this time alifanya hivi na hivi. In this time alifanya hivi na hivi. Can we trust him even now? The Bible says, those promises that he made to the children of Israel, none of them missed. Yani zote. Yani hakuna ile Mungu aliwaambia, yani hii sitaweza. Sitaweza kuwapigania na Amorites. Sitaweza hawa. Every promise that God made, aliwaambia nitawakomboa kutoka Egypt. I will deliver you with my powerful hand. Did God deliver the children of Israel? He did. He told them, I'm going to take you to a land flowing with milk and honey. Did God do it? Yes. And today, we can look at the track record of God. Yani tunaweza angalia nyuma, tuone jinsi Mungu amekuwa mwaminifu na watoto wake. Wale ambao walitutangulia, Mungu alifanya nini na maisha yao? Kuna mmoja ambaye Mungu aliita akamfail? There is none. Amen. Even for Moses, he was a stammerer. Wengine wetu, we don't even know how to. You know, sometimes I look at myself and I say, God, I don't deserve to go on that pulpit. That is what I was saying, but God, by your grace. Amen. It is by the grace of God. Hallelujah. You know, Moses was a stammerer. Na kwa nini Mungu alitafuta just a stammerer to come and deliver the children of Israel? Because he's an able God. And he can use anything for his own glory. Amen. Let us read in the book of 2 Chronicles 6:15-17. You have kept what you promised your servant David, my father. You have both spoken with your mouth and fulfilled it with your hand. Imagine. Huyu Solomon anaangalia. Alijua ya kwamba Mungu alikuwa ananenea baba yake Daudi. Anasema ya kwamba Mungu, now he's telling God, God, whatever you spoke to my father David, you have fulfilled it. You spoke it and you performed it with your own hands. You are looking at the track record of God. Si mtu anaongea juu ya track record ya Mungu. Yani Mungu umekuwa mwaminifu. Whatever you promised my father, you have fulfilled it even now. He's saying, but you have both spoken with your mouth and fulfilled it with your hand. And it is as it is this day. Yani siku hii Mungu, nikiangalia matendo yako, yale uliahidi baba yangu umeshatenda. And he was praying. Amen. The track record of God is so clear. Genesis 28:12-15, the Bible says, I will not leave you, to somebody 15b, I will not leave you until I have done that which I have promised you. And whatever you want to be, have God promised you anything in this life? Has God promised you anything according to his word? How do we know the promises of God? Unajua watu wengine wanataka manabii watoke huko wakuja waambie jinsi Mungu anavyosema katika maisha yake. Lakini Biblia yangu ndio inanipeana promises. Amen. You know, the Bible is your promise book. We are not waiting for a prophet to come here. We are not waiting for tellers to come and tell us what the Lord has said. Amen. When the Bible has spoken of it, God talks to us through His Word. His promises are written in His Word. Amen. Biblia inasema ya kwamba God was telling Jacob, I will not leave you, sitakuacha mimi mpaka nitimize kenye nimekuahidi. Hiyo ndio siku hii ya leo. I want to tell you, even you child of God, kama unataka, kama Mungu amekunenea, you will be great. I want to tell you, if God spoke it, He is able to perform it and it will happen. No matter what. Hey, no matter what. The purposes of God has to come to pass. Najua shetani wakati mwingine anakimbianga to prevent the purposes of God. But the purposes of God has to come to pass in my life and your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. And every promise that my Father has made me, it is mine. Amen. It is mine and for my children. It is yours for your people and your children. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, amen. Number three, the integrity of God is what makes us believe in His promises. The integrity. Unajua ukisema mtu ako na integrity, unamaanisha nini? Huyu mtu ako, yani integrity, I don't know how to put it in good terms, lakini huyu mtu habadiliki. Integrity. Ukisikia mtu ni mtu wa integrity, cheo yake iko juu sana. Maana anachosema ndicho anafanya. And I pray that all of us, we may be women and men of integrity. Even to the community, may we become men and women of integrity. Yakoba, when you say a yes is an yes, when you say a no is a no. Amen. You know, our God has integrity. He's not like us. The Bible says in the book of Numbers 23:19, God is not a man that he should repent, neither a son of man that he should change his mind. Does he speak and does he not act? Does he promise and not fulfill? Ya kwamba, Mungu wetu si kama mwanadamu. Mungu wetu hawezi danganya. Mungu wetu anaahidi na anatenda ambacho aliahidi. Amen. Kama Mungu alituahidi, this is our year of divine meeting. He's going to lift us if we stay in Him. Amen. This is our year and our decade of great exploits. I have laid a foundation. Why do you believe in the promises of God? Because He is able, because His track record is true, and because of His integrity. I want us now to check how to receive the promises of God. How do you receive the promises of God? Yani Mungu umeshaniahidi uponyaji. Nitapokea huu uponyaji aje? Mungu umeniahidi watoto wangu watabarikiwa. How do I receive this? Let me tell you, the promises of God, they are received by faith. It is just by faith. Yani, the Bible says in the book of Hebrews 11:6, whoever comes to God must believe that He is, and He is a rewarder to those who seek Him diligently. Ya kwamba Mungu is not pleased when we don't have faith in Him. Amen. You know, you have to have faith. And I want you to start praying from today. Mungu akuongeze imani yako. Tuanze kuamini mambo makubwa. God, has He promised breakthrough? Yes, I believe it with all my heart. And faith is not in the head. Faith is at the heart. Just like the way we believe with our heart and confess with our mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord. The true faith comes from the heart. See here, Kichwa. Kichwa, itaanza kureason. You know, when you put reasoning in the spiritual things, then you're not going to do it. But when you put faith, yani faith inatakana mtu ni kama mjinga. Mungu umesha sema, ninaamini katika jina la Yesu with your heart. Amen. I want to give you the first thing. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews 6:12, imitate those through faith and patience. Inherit what has been promised.